I've got with me on Skype today Andrew Day from Keywords Studios. Andrew, good morning.
Morning, Andrew.
You got your results out this morning here, Andrew, plus word on a couple of new acquisitions. Let's take a look at the results first off. Another strong year here for you, plus two of your biggest acquisitions to date, of course. Give us a quick recap on the year, Andrew. You pleased?
Yeah, very pleased. In fact, I'm delighted to be sharing the results with you today. Another strong set, a bit ahead of expectations in general. And, you know, big thank you again to all fellow Keywordians around the world for producing these stellar results. So really, really chuffed. Revenue's up nicely. In fact, on a pro forma basis, which we don't normally talk about, but I think it's, you know, the way to look at this business, given how many acquisitions we make. We're actually at 225 million euros of revenue for last year, which gives us a very sort of solid starting point for 2018. Profits up nicely as well, 57% if you look at EBITDA. Finished the year with good net cash, as we usually do, 11 million in net cash. And also bolstered our credit facility to give us a bit more firepower for acquisitions. So very pleasing picture overall.
And you're looking at a 10% increase, are you, in the final divvy?
Yep, as we normally do, given, you know, we continue to progress and grow our profitability, we're increasing the dividend in line with our progressive dividend policy.
Those acquisitions I mentioned a moment ago, VMC, Sparasoft, remind us about those. How are they settling in?
Yeah, they're going very well, thanks. Both fairly large acquisitions for us. In fact, VMC, the largest acquisition we've made to date, at about $55 million dollars of revenue. The team over in North America have got to grips with that acquisition very quickly, and we've almost completed the integration of the business. Including combining four facilities into one in Seattle, where we already had two existing Keywords studios, doing some sort of rejigging of things in the Montreal area, where both VMC and Keywords have substantial premises. And harmonizing management teams, implementing Keywords operating systems, IT systems, moving payroll systems, and so on and so forth. So they've got to grips with that very, very quickly. So very pleased with that. Sparasoft has taken us into Russia and Poland in particular, which opens up some very interesting talent pools for us. Business is going very, very well indeed. Already landed some nice new projects early on in the year, given that it only joined us in December 2017. So it didn't have much of an impact on our reported results, but we're looking forward to big contributions this year.
And acquisitions to one side, Andrew, what about organic growth? How's that going?
Yeah, it remains very strong. I think we've reported like-for-like growth of about 15%. There are other ways of doing organic growth. If you were to strip out the acquisitions altogether, both this year and last year, I think you would have got a picture of about 18% underlying growth. So we're reporting in a consistent fashion. We're showing 15% organic growth, which is pretty good. I know it's down a little bit from the 20% that we reported in previous years, but we're a much larger business. So it's natural that the growth in terms of percentage measure will sort of tail a little bit as we continue to grow the overall value of our revenues.
And in typical fashion, as I alluded to at the start there, news of a couple of further acquisitions this morning, Chord Worldwide and Laced Music. Andrew, talk to me about these.
Yeah, very exciting for us. So as you know, Andrew, we've got an audio service line where we kind of lead the world in the production of voiced audio for video games. What we haven't done so far up until this point is enter the music space or indeed the sound effects space, both of which are interesting markets for video games. So Chord and Laced take us very firmly into the market for music services. Laced is already servicing the video games field, whereas Chord is more focused on major brands, international brands like Shell, BT, Lego, and so on. where they provide their expertise in managing music assets, whether that's arranging music to be composed specifically or licensed in music and managing those licensed assets. And they have a particular presence in what's called audio branding, where we're able to associate the sound, a particular sound with a particular brand. And that's something that we're looking to introduce into the video games space, so that we can associate the big IPs, you know, the Assassin's Creed's, the Call of Duties and so on of this world, with an ongoing kind of sound of the brand or of particular characters within the brand. So very pleased with that, and looking forward to exploiting their, you know, market leading expertise in the video game space.
And you'll be looking to keep much of the teams on from Cordon Laced?
Oh, absolutely, all of them. Yeah.
Excellent.
Yeah, very much so.
One acquisition we didn't talk about at the time, but a slightly smaller one, Maximal Studio. This was completed on the 22nd of March.
Yeah, we've just chosen to inform the market. It's very small, so it's not something that we need to talk about from a regulatory point of view. But it's nice to keep everybody up to date. So we're just using the opportunity of communicating with the market today to let them know that we've also done this one. It's an existing supplier of ours of audio recording services, voice recording services in the Brazilian market. So it comes with three recording studios and obviously a familiar team to us. And it just gives us a little bit more weight to our existing activities in Brazil, where we have a presence in Rio de Janeiro at the moment.
Right. Well, as far as acquisitions are concerned for the year ahead, Andrew, what are you on the lookout for?
Yeah, it's a good question. I mean, you should expect us to continue to make, you know, a good number of these sort of smaller acquisitions. And obviously, if we find something larger, we won't shy away from that either. But it's across the board. As you know, we have the seven service lines. Most of those service lines are on the lookout for particular expertise to add to them to extend the range of their capabilities. But we're also looking for acquisitions that give us further scale in order to provide the services in a more robust or a more flexible manner to our existing clients. So both of those, a little bit perhaps less than in the past, is the kind of geographic driver. We've got a footprint that's very international. We're not hugely driven by a desire to go and implant ourselves in particular geographies, because we have a, you know, very good footprint already. So expect a little bit more of the same, but just infilling some expertise here and there.
And you're looking forward to the year ahead, Andrew. As always, I'm sure it'll be busy for you.
Very much so. I mean, we feel that momentum is building. You know, it still feels very much like we're just getting started on our journey here. So while we look back at last year and sort of congratulate ourselves on a job well done, when I look forward, you know, my level of excitement really, really, really increases. So I think we've got a tremendous future ahead.
Great to see you, Andrew. Thanks very much.
Thanks a lot, Andrew. Take care.